Good morning, students. Today we will be discussing about the topic relating to the fluid flow. It is a part of the topic or the subject that we study in kinematics of the fluid mechanics. And today the topic of discussion will be Bernoulli's theorem. So let's go forward with it. As we know before, that Bernoulli's theorem stands for a particular existing relationship between kinetic head, atom head and velocity. Before going through the Bernoulli's theorem, you should be always be aware that what exactly kinetic head, atom head and velocity head is. As you can see, this particular formula states, between the motion of the fluid in one particular point from towards another particular point, while the fluid in a motion within the pipeline, then we can say the different type of the head summation is equal. As you can see, by means of expression of the formula, we go forward, P by rho g, that is the pressure head, g square by rho g, that is the velocity head, and z, that is your atom head. At one particular point, in a motion of the fluid within a pipe, we can say that these three heads at these two different points will be equal in summation. So, in short, we can say P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1, which is the component of the total energy at one particular point, one in a pipe, equals to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2, which is the respective total heads at another different point. So this particular equation stands with collaboration with the Bernoulli's theorem. Here P1 and P2 are the pressure and section 1 and 2 respectively, and also V1 and V2 are the velocity of the fluid flow at section 1 and 2 respectively. And here the Z1 and Z2 are the datum head, or the height of the water from the reference datum respectively. If we go by definition of Bernoulli's theorem, then it states that for an ideal and incompressible fluid flow, the total energy or total head at one section will be definitely equal to the total head at another section. By the help of this formula, we can determine pressure, velocity and datum head of the respective sections if we have another size detail, such as assistance of the velocity and diameter of the particular pipe in that particular section. Using the continuity equation, as we know, Q is equal to A into V. It states that total amount of discharge or quantity of the discharge will be the product of area of cross section of the pipe and velocity at that particular cross section. So, these two formulas will be actually and adamantly necessary for evaluation of very particular detail in fluid mechanics. In future, when you will be studying the motion and dynamicity of the fluid flow, these two formulas will be coherently used in collaboration. But this particular formula has also various limitations. Just like any other formula or any other topics of engineering, it also has its assumption. Assumptions means in the format of application in practicality. The first assumption it has is the liquid has to be in ideal and incompressible state of nature. And the second assumption will be the flow is steady and continuous. Third assumption will be the flow is along the streamline, means every single line or the layers of the water fluid flow is assumed to be streamly in nature. The fourth assumption or the limitation is the velocity is uniform over the section and is equal at every single part or even the edge or the center of the pipe. There are certain practical applications of this Bernoulli's theorem. As we know, motion of the object in the fluid is comprehensively useful when we talk about underwater movement. In the underwater construction, or we can say oil well construction, and also the motion of the submarine underwater is really a significant topic of relation and application in practical basis of Bernoulli's theorem. The submarine that is flying or the traveling inside the heavy pressure water is actually works on the principle of continuity equation and Bernoulli's theorem. Here, the pressure is calculated on the basis of the datum it had with respect to Earth's surface and is equated inside the pressure and which will collaborate the kind of the material required and the kind of the construction need to be synthesized in order to maintain the smooth movement of the submarine. The second working principle will be an aeroplane. Bernoulli's theorem is useful in determining the shape and the motion of the air while an aeroplane is on the movement. The third application will be an action of the atmospheric pressure, or we can say atomizer. It is one of the scientific research on the basis of which the atomic reactors are generated or created in order to work comprehensively to generate electricity as its byproduct and minimizing the waste. The fourth application will be the blowing of the roof by the wind. As we can see, in during the time of a cyclone or a particular hazard, the roofs of the building gets eradicated or destroyed by the wind speed. There, we can prevent this particular phenomenon using Bernoulli's theorem. The fifth application will be anturimeter, which is quite popular in research field in fluid mechanics.